I was reading one of the research article of Food and Agriculture Organization. India has the ultimate irrigation potential around 140 million hectares. We haven't reached this figure. However, it is estimated that even after achieving the full irrigation potential, nearly 50% of the total cultivated area will remain rain-fed. This poses a risk to our food security in the face of climate change. Like countries, Israel, one of the best examples, has achieved remarkable progress in the agriculture given the relative scarcity of water. What lessons from them can we implement in India to reduce our dependency on rain?
Yes, we are a water-stressed countries, but still like we can't put blame on nature, as you have given example of Israel. Like that, there are many examples. Yes. First, coming to numbers, this ultimate irrigation potential number, it varies and yes. It doesn't remain fixed. Long back, Professor A. Vaidyanathan, he calculated what is the ultimate irrigation potential for India. If I remember it correctly, I think it was enough to give irrigation to at least 70% of the land under cultivation. Yes. 50% number of FAO may be wrong, or maybe yes. You have read it wrong, because already we have reached close to 50%. The area that is under irrigation right now is close to 50%, yes, and yes. We know that we can go very far. Yes. Then second is that it is water which matters. Can we make water available to the crop either through irrigation or through some other means? So when we are talking of har khet ko pani, when yes. Some people asked me, I told them, yes, it may not be possible to give flood irrigation to all khet, but it's possible to ensure that water saving kind of water is available for every field, and that is doable. How that is doable? Our water use efficiency is one of the lowest in the world if you compare with the countries. Yes. Compared to many other agriculturally advanced countries, we use 2 times the water they use to produce 1 ton of food. Which means if we are able to attain water use efficiency, not of Israel is yes. exception. If we are able to attain water use efficiency level of say China, of USA, of even Brazil, even with the same quantity of water, we can double our area under irrigation. You see, that subsequently yes. We may discuss it in more detail. Yes. Now, if we have a policy of free power or highly subsidized power or fixed power, 100 yeah. rupee per horsepower or 200 rupee per horsepower, we are creating incentive to the farmer to overuse water.
Oh, yes.
And then you see, we though always talk about water scarcity, but when it comes to pricing of water, when it comes to valuing water, hardly this kind of situation is visible in our decision making.
Yes.
First is that if we improve our water use efficiency, we can make lot of difference.
We
just double our present level of irrigation, even if we do not further overuse our water, use our water sources. That is the scope of expanding irrigation through improvement in water use efficiency. Secondly, you know that most of the farmer, there are few who go for this sprinkler irrigation or yes. drip kind of irrigation. They all go for flood irrigation. So in case of flood irrigation, you know it, that how much wastage of water is there.
Yes, yes.
Not even 40% water actually reaches the plant. So I feel that we are a water-stressed country. But we also have opportunities that we can meet all our entire need if we value water, if we price water properly. And it is not only in agriculture, even in a city like Delhi, there are no water meters. And you want people to make economic use of water. You see, the use of these natural resources must be reflected in the opportunity cost. We must realize what is the opportunity cost of 100 liter water that I am using. Yes. And the pricing of water must be done according to that. So maybe subsequently we will deal with it in more detail. But I would say that that it is not so much because we do not have availability of water. It is more because we are not using water judiciously. We are not making use of water in efficient manners. So we can expand our area under irrigation without additional water to 70%, 75% with the right kind of water use efficiency.
Yes, yes, yes. That's perfect, sir, because we have to use it efficiently, especially in our daily life in the urban centers as well. Like I personally save RO water as well, that wastage of RO water, and we use for washing clothes. So that is how like people can use it efficiently. That's great, sir.